We talked a lot about configuring your databases and managed instance after you deploy. But when it comes to performance, there are other tasks involved for configuring and maintaining that perf. While many things are the same with SQL Server, understanding some of the defaults and the options that are available can help you hit the ground running. So Bob, you know, what are some things people should consider when it comes to performance?
Yeah, that's right, Anna. There are things specific to configuring performance for Azure SQL that are going to feel a little bit like SQL Server, but a little different for the cloud that you need to know about. And one of the things, first of all, that comes to my mind is Tempdb. Boy, this is just an area of configuration pain for customers over the years. But in SQL Server, we've made this better. One of the things we've done is auto-configure the number of files for Tempdb to help you place out, you know, your allocation space within Tempdb to kind of reduce lash contention. And what we've done for Tempdb and Azure SQL is we've kind of done similar to SQL Server. We're going to scale the number of files for you depending on how you've deployed. So, example, in general purpose, we'll scale the number of files depending on how many vCores you've deployed. We're always going to keep Tempdb on local SSD drives for maximum performance. And since this gets recreated each time, even if you fail over, it doesn't necessarily matter. They're on these local SSD drives. So don't worry about Tempdb IO. You know, we've got that one figured out for you. And a lot of you do that in your deployments. You can get 12 files with managed instance available. So we don't necessarily scale that one for you depending on vCores. Some of the options you pick that we've done with trace flags over the years, they're through altered database options. Those options are appropriately set up for you just like are in SQL Server, but in MI, you could actually change those. And then finally, the Tempdb metadata optimization that's there in SQL 19, it's not available quite yet for Azure SQL, but we expect that to be coming soon, both for database and managed instance. You know, Anna talked in a previous module about loading data. This is a very important point. In order to meet our SLAs, we need to use full recovery for Azure SQL databases and in managed instance. And so you cannot use minimal logging for bulk operations. So it's kind of important for you to consider that. And you could run into some transaction log rate governance scenarios. So getting those batch sizes correctly and keeping in mind about bulk import, you need to keep that in mind. Now, you can bulk import to Tempdb, though. That is set up to do minimal logging there. So that's an option for you if it doesn't meet your needs for your database. File groups are interesting. You know, file groups is something that's used a lot for physical placement of files in your SQL Server environment in many cases, but we don't support you going and configuring physical placement of files. Now, we have found because of the performance guarantees we have around our different tiers and options that that doesn't really matter. As long as we can support the number of IOPS and latencies for you, you know, having the ability for you to move your files on different drives, not having that in Azure, we don't believe that's an issue for you. In fact, it kind of takes a burden off you. So it is possible that the number of files you do and the size of the files in, say, like a managed instance environment can be important and can affect IO performance. We got some detailed documentation on managed instance on how you can kind of tweak that a little bit. Because we're using Azure storage in the background, and the number and size of these files can affect and get and gain you performance. Now, max degree of parallelism is something that is really, really important to customers. And we have all the different options you need with SQL Server and managed instance to go support this. So for example, alter database scope configuration, which we introduced in SQL 16, that is there for you to control max DOP. Managed instance supports SP configure just like a SQL Server, so you can control max DOP for the entire instance if you need in, say, managed instance. We allow query hints, and managed instance also supports resource governor for you to configure max degree of parallelism. And then finally, resource governor itself, as a feature, behind the scenes, we do use resource governor to support some of our limits, but at managed instance, we'll give you access to user-defined workload groups and pools for your own resource governor needs. So these are some interesting areas of configuration for performance, where these are topics very familiar to you as a SQL Server user, but some differences that you need to keep in mind as you're configuring performance for Azure SQL and managed instance. Now, maintenance is really interesting. As I talk with Anna about building, like, how do people maintain performance for Azure SQL and SQL Server? The two things that come to mind are maintaining indexes and statistics. Well, here's the good news. Everything you're used to using in SQL Server is simply there for you, even automatic statistics being used at database level. So when you think about rebuilding your indexes or reorging indexes or using statistics from an auto perspective or even maintaining your own stats, all those things are capable and available for you in both Azure SQL database and in managed instance. So in this video, we talked about configuring and maintaining performance. feels a lot like SQL Server. Differences you need to be aware of when it comes to things even like Tempdb, bulk, you know, being able to have, having full recovery for loading, using the indexes, maintaining statistics. Again, feels like SQL, a little bit different for Azure SQL. Stay tuned in the next video as we continue to talk about how to optimize performance for Azure SQL.